Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Totalbiscuit. Welcome to my 250,000 subscriber video. I've been trying to get this together for a while, but this kind of thing does take some time. Firstly, I'd like to thank everyone who has helped contribute to the 250, which is now actually 260,000 subscribers to the Total Halibut channel. It is always very humbling to see the subscriber numbers go up every single day, and I trip over my words because I find it so emotional, trust me. It's really great to have one's work validated. And let's be honest, the work consists of making silly video game videos. And I think when I started doing this, the aim was to try and, to some degree, kind of raise the bar in terms of the content that was available in terms of just straight up video game commentaries. And just show people that, look, video game commentaries don't have to be awkward, stuttering, stammering nonsense over a cheap microphone, or indeed some guy yelling into a mic very loudly and having it clip over the limit and deafen you. I think that gamers do deserve better media, and I think that gaming has gotten to the point where it absolutely should have better media, and I'm trying in my own small way to do that, and hopefully, eventually, after enough work, enough practice, enough effort put into it, I'll be able to really give you guys the product that I actually want to give you. But hopefully you guys are liking the channel so far. And what I want to do for this 250,000 subscriber video is to try and show you my favorite game of all time, which is this one. The music. Ugh, nerd chills, what can I say? I just want to give you a bit of insight into what I think is a great game, because to me, this is the epitome of PC gaming, and indeed gaming in general. It, to me, is the best game of all time. I believe this thoroughly, without question, and without even a slightest kernel of doubt in my heart. I believe this is the best game ever made. So, we're going to play this. I don't know for how long. I'm just going to keep going on with it, and I'm going to show you as much of it as I can, and I'll try and tell you as much about Deus Ex as possible. And indeed, my hopes for Deus Ex 3, which will be out very, very soon. It goes by the name of Human Revolution, and my God, I hope it's better than the second one. We'll talk about the second one a little bit as well. This is all a live recording, so there won't be any editing of any description here. You're just going to get a little bit of a stream of consciousness, which, let's be honest, is what most of my videos consist of anyway. Without further ado, let's kick it off. So, mods-wise, I'm not really using anything other than the DirectX 10 renderer and a couple of mods to correct the aspect ratio and things like that. So, aside from that, I haven't put anything in. We're going to play it on realistic, which is the hardest difficulty. There we go. Codename, indeed. So, those of you not familiar with Deus Ex might want to know exactly why it's the best game of all time. And the first thing is that it's not really an FPS. It's a first-person RPG in a cyberpunk-style world. So we'll see exactly what goes on with this. And what you have here is a list of skills which you can train. Now, you level up these skills throughout the game. This is what you start with. You have 5,000 skill points to allocate. You can also pick 5 different appearances. There we go. The most badass JC Denton is this one. So we shall pick that. Now, skills-wise, don't ever get swimming. Swimming's so bad. This game is not without its problems. When I say it's the best game of all time, it's because everything about this game supersedes the problems and blatant design issues that it has. It is that good. For instance, that and that are pretty much useless. You really, really do not need that. This is a bit better than swimming. Swimming is awful. Environmental training, yeah, you can justify at least maybe taking a little bit in it. And that is quite a cheap skill anyway. Aside from that, you have 5 different weapon skills. This will affect your accuracy. You start with 1 in pistol. Very useful. Pistol, you can beat the entire game with pistols. You can beat the entire game with melee weapons. I've done that as well. I've beaten this game probably about 7 or 8 times, but the last time I played it, I think, was a good 2 years ago, so I think I'm going to have to relearn it. Computer, electronics, lockpicking, swimming, that kind of thing. We don't want swimming. Nobody wants swimming! Ugh. Rifle is always kind of nice if you want to be using sniper rifles and things like that, but I tend to go with the pistols and the sort of stealthier approach, so we'll probably go with that. I could take something in computing. That's probably a good idea. Getting computing means, at least in trained, means that you can at least get into certain consoles. Like, for instance, if you're untrained in computer hacking, you're not going to be able to hack anything. You just can't do it. So that's one avenue of skill that is taken away from you. It's a possibility of getting through a certain level that you can no longer do. You just can't do it. Electronics you can kind of do anyway, because electronics requires the use of a multi-tool. Multi-tools you can just pick up. Same with lockpicking, you can do it anyway, but it takes more lockpicks and more multi-tools to get past a particular area if that's the situation you're in. Whereas with computer, you can't do anything otherwise, and the ability to at least hack ATMs and get cash out of them is very handy. Aside from that, weapons-wise, yeah, heavy in demolitions and things like that. It depends what kind of character you want to go. If you want to go with a full-on gun guy, you might be wanting to get some rifles and some heavy. You can get a rocket launcher very early on in the game, but good luck finding the ammunition for it. Demolitions, always nice to get a little bit of this. It's mostly just to help you out with grenades. Grenades are available in a wide variety of different forms, and they are handy. No question about that. They can do a lot of damage, and also you gain the ability to at least pick up grenades that are armed and used as landmines. They can be deployed on surfaces. You can get closer to them and grab them before they detonate. So if you're untrained, then they're going to detonate pretty damn fast. In unrealistic mode, it will probably kill you if it's an explosive grenade. Yeah, nasty stuff. Medicine, always nice to get because it allows you to heal slightly more damage. I'm going to take a rank in this simply because it's really hard on realistic. So being able to heal slightly more damage is very, very good. No, you cannot, in fact, perform a hard bypass with household materials, but it's close enough. Now what we might do is we might take another rank in pistol. And I'm going to do the first level, I think, in a sort of stealthy manner. We're not going to bother exploiting a lot of the lockpicking stuff and things like that. I'm just going to go with this and we could use some grenades, I suppose. Maybe, just maybe. Or I could, of course, just save the points. Bear in mind, you get points for doing other things as well. So you don't have to spend the whole lot at the start, so we're not going to do that. Right, that looks reasonable. We can go with that. Bear in mind, there are no really wrong choices, with the exception of swimming. Everything else is valid. You can beat the game with it. And that's one of the great things about it. So let's kick it off right now, shall we? Okay, go, go, go. You know you want to work.
Your appointment to FEMA should be finalized within the week. I've already discussed the matter.
It's an old game. There are graphics issues.
He didn't really have a choice.
Has he been infected?
Oh, yes. Most certainly.
Indeed. Those are bad guys. We can just skip the intro for the time being. You should really play this game at some point anyway. We're not going to go too far into the plot in this particular playthrough. A trash can. Yes, we can throw it, if we so wish. Not particularly effective. What do you start with? This pistol. 10mm pistol. A prod. This is a really powerful weapon. Surprisingly enough. This electric cattle prod. Very good. Medkits. And this key ring. Which obviously relies on you actually getting keys for it. Aside from that, that is pretty much it.
Heads up, JC. Your brother Paul is on his way to meet you at the dock. The NSF is raiding the island and shots have been fired. I repeat, find Paul. I will monitor your situation from HQ.
Yes, indeed. Alex has a lot of interesting things to tell you, but what we're going to do is we're going to adjust this because it's very important that we have less sound and more music because the music is by an artist called Alexander Brandon. You might be aware of this guy because he did the music for Unreal Tournament. Yes. And it is amazing. Oh, it's so good. Really is so.
I spill my drink.
The voice acting on the other hand, as you can tell, probably not so much, but never mind. Right, okay. So, let's try and actually remember how to play this game. Well, for one thing, C and control aren't crouch. I believe it's X. Yes, it's X for crouch. There is no iron sight, but you can add a zoom onto these particular weapons. It's an upgrade. You might notice there a crosshair system. This is, it's a little odd, and I'd like to show you more, but it looks like we're going to have a conversation.
Paul, I thought you were in Hong Kong. Welcome to the Coalition, JC. I might as well start using your code name. Think I'd miss my brother's first day? Didn't think you'd have a choice. What's going on? The NSF. They hit one of our shipments. A few of them got away, but we trapped the rest in the statue. What are we waiting for? Looks like a textbook assault. The NSF took one of our agents hostage. The bots are holding the perimeter, but my orders are to hold back and send you in alone. I think someone high up wants to see how you handle the situation.
All I've got with me is a pistol and an electric prod. I don't mind a test, but Unaco better issue some hardware.
Remember that we're police. Stick with the prod. It'll stun your opponents or knock them unconscious. A non-lethal takedown is always the most silent way to eliminate resistance. Just in case, though, Manderly wants you to pick an additional weapon. A sniper rifle, a gep gun, or a mini crossbow.
So yes, you do get choices in this game. There are many conversations. Again, this has to be treated as an RPG, because that's effectively what it is. It is not a first-person shooter, per se. It's more of an RPG than anything else, although FPS skill is, to some degree, taken into account. Right. Again, I want to go with a stealthier approach. The mini crossbow is an amazing weapon. It has a variety of different ammunition types, and one of them will pretty much take down a normal grunt dead. Not so much dead, but unconscious, which is good enough. And it's... You'll see. You will see. Trust me. We're gonna go with that.
The crossbow. Sometimes you've gotta make a silent takedown. Good thinking. With these tranquilizer darts, you'll have another non-lethal way to take down an enemy in addition to the prod. I get the idea. What's the first move? I'm going to give you a map of the island. If you can get to the North Dock, a UNATCO informant will give you a key to the statue doors. He responds to the code phrase, iron and copper. You could avoid a lot of fighting, though, if you found a back way to the statue.
I'll see how it looks on shore.
Your primary objective is the makeshift command center the terrorists have installed at the top of the statue. But don't forget about Agent Harriman. We think he's being held on the ground floor.
What are my orders when I reach the command center?
Interrogate the leader. We don't yet know why the terrorists would risk an open assault.
There we go. Right. So, inventory. iKey will give you access to pretty much everything you've got. The inventory is designed in this sort of box shape, and certain items will take up multiple boxes. So, inventory capacity is... Well, some people call it inventory Tetris. There's a reason for that. Right, you also have a variety of different ammunition types. You can see right there, we have 4 rounds of non-lethal tranquilizer darts, 6 rounds of 10mm ammunition, and 4 rounds of the prod. There is other ammo to be found. This right here will show you the health that you have. You can take damage in different areas, and these areas will give you different effects. For instance, you take medium wounds to your torso, you will have impaired movement. Wounds to the head, not so great. Yes, wavering vision, slightly decreased accuracy, things like that, not so great at all. You can lose your left and right arms. You can lose your legs. They can be blown off, or they can be healed with medkits. No, it doesn't make an awful lot of sense, but there you go. Right. Skills, we've seen these before. This is what we had access to. This is what we have. We have advanced pistols, so this will make taking folks down an awful lot easier. Shooting with any weapon you are not trained with is really hard, because the cone of fire goes down very slowly and the weapons are highly inaccurate. Goals, and you've got conversations, you also have logs there, and you can also add notes if you so desire. Very important. Right. Okay, so images, that will sort of show us the vague area of this. And one of the genius things about this game is just how many ways there are to approach a particular objective. I can think of maybe 8 or 9 ways to beat this level in different fashions. So as to which one we'll use, well, we'll just see what happens. If I'm totally honest, I don't even know which one we're going to go with.
What's your take on the situation, Corporal?
The bots have them bottled up, sir. We'd go right in if it weren't for the whole back order.
How'd they get one of our agents?
Gunter went rogue on us. When the order came, he wouldn't pull back. Now you get to bail him out.
Super. Happy fun time, ladies and gentlemen. You can talk to NPCs if you
Welcome
wish.
Welcome aboard, Agent.
You can continue to do so. If I want to go talk to him again, I can, but there's no real point because we're not going to get anything out of it. Right, items-wise, crowbar is in fact a weapon, some good old Half-Life. This is actually a lethal weapon, so you want to be just a little bit careful if you decide to make use of this, but it is useful for breaking open crates. A pair of binoculars, also nice to have, as well as a lockpick. Lockpicks are temporary use. Now, there's a secret under here, if I remember correctly. Let's go for a little bit of a swim. But Totalbiscuit, you said no swimming skill. We don't need it, because under this little cage right here, there are a few additional items. There is a multi-tool, which will allow us to bypass electronic locks, and this, which is a bioelectric cell, which will allow us to recharge our bioelectric abilities, of which we don't have any right now, other than a flashlight. Yes, we do not need the light right now. Thank you very much. So we can... without question, do without it for the time being. Right. Don't shoot at the security bots. They will get rather annoyed. Those are incredibly dangerous at this stage of the game and will kill you very quickly. Not nice. Not at all.
NSF everywhere, JC. Your orders are to shoot on sight. A UNATCO informant on the North Dock can get you inside the statue. Look for a bum. Identify yourself with the phrase, iron and copper.
Yes, indeed. Right, okay, so we do, in fact, have some ammunition for this, and we've got some ammunition for this. However, again, on this particular level, I am not going to kill anything that I don't have to. I'll try and minimize it as much as possible. And yes, because crossbows are always more badass if you wear them on your arm, that's what's going to be happening right here.
If you want to make a covert approach, remember the Academy stealth course. Stay out of their field of view, walk slowly to stay quiet, and crouch behind cover. Or if you have to get your hands dirty, remember that a headshot is a lethal takedown.
Oh yes. Bear in mind, interacting with the environment is quite important here, and you do want to be careful about the amount of noise that you make. The actual view distance, even on realistic, of a lot of the enemies is not particularly high. But on realistic, they will kill you very fast, especially since you are unaugmented. You don't have the kind of things that will allow you to survive an awful lot longer later in the game. Nano augmentations are available, and they are indeed essential for beating the later stages of this particular game. Right now, we're not so bothered about that. I just have to be a little bit careful with what we do here. Make sure we don't make too much noise. Like I say, the guys don't have a massive sight range anyway. And funnily enough, that sort of adds to the charm of the game. It allows you to do things that in other games wouldn't actually be possible, like sneaking around and getting access to things that you really wouldn't expect yourself to be able to do. Stay behind here. Now, these guys all sort of have patrol paths, so he can't actually see me here, because again, they have sort of a very limited field of view. I'm gonna go and give him a bit of a prod, literally. Do-do-do-do-do, sneaky, 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 get nice and close, and bam! There we go. Nice and easy. Little bit of ammo, and again, we're gonna go for a totally non-lethal playthrough of this particular level. I have a couple of weapons which will allow me to do that. I do also now have a baton. The baton is nice. It doesn't do as much damage as the crowbar, but it is significantly better because it allows you to do a non-lethal takedown. You'll notice the base damage there. Actually, it does more base damage by the looks of it. Never mind. I did not know that. There you go. You see base accuracy stats and everything like that. Again, it does perform like an RPG, so I don't really want to use the crowbar on that. Why indeed would we need to if the baton does more damage? Okay, so this guy can't see me at the moment, but he's going to be able to. So what I want to try and do is take him down with the tranquilizer dart. The best thing you can do with this is to take... Oh God, he's spotted me already, hasn't he? Are there any alarms around here? Nope, nope, there are not. Okay. Right, okay. So he's decided he's going to take on the security bot. Not particularly smart idea to do. There we go. Now, obviously, I didn't kill him there, so, you know, my non-lethal play is still fine. Now, that would be a sort of full-on attack if we were to go in this way. We're not going to go that way yet because the base is available over here. This is actually a friendly base. This is the UNATCO HQ here on Liberty Island. Not much left of the Statue of Liberty, as you can see. It was destroyed in a terrorist bombing at one point in the storyline of this particular game. So, if we have a word with this fellow, we can actually pick up some items.
This is under lockdown till the danger's gone, Agent Denton.
Right. How you guys holding up?
UNATCO Command made us pull back. I guess for Gunther's sake. What's the deal? We're ready to go in.
Now, two options here. This one tends to get you the best response. We don't want to go with a minimum force approach. It tends to piss him off. This will actually get us some information.
I can't speak for Command, but I'm going to clean the place out.
I hear you. Natalie's right. Nano-orgs are born and bred killers.
I do my best.
Better load up. There are some crates of ammo stashed in the antenna shaft behind the helipad. Might also want to check out the comm van next to it. The code's 0451.
Thanks. I won't let you down.
My tactic, when there's no cover like this, is to pick them off from 50 or 100 paces with a scope. What do you think? I scored an extra one from a couple of thugs we dropped down by the dock. You can have it for 700 credits. I also picked up some 10mm ammo and some crossbow tranquilizer darts. Say, 200 for one, and 60 for the other.
Shouldn't you turn that stuff over to the quartermaster?
Sure, I will. As long as Command has the rest of us on parade drill, someone might as well put this hardware to use.
A valid point. You can get enough for the scope eventually, but I don't believe you can do that until after this level's over, but I will certainly take the tranq darts.
Here's 60 for the tranquilizer darts.
Time to clean house.
Yes, indeed. 60 credits for tranquilizer darts. So, so very good. ammo is quite limited in this game, so you've got to be very sparing with it. In fact, ammo in general is quite limited, so you do have to be a little bit careful with what you do. Alright, so, yes, yeah, so the famous code, those of you who have played this game before will be well aware of 0451, which I believe is also being used in Deus Ex 3 as a nice little homage. Now, I think the key, yes, the key was stashed under there, if I remember correctly. 0451, thank you very much. Some more track dart, and fantastic, data cube. That is the password, and that is the login. Now, these computer terminals are located all over the game, and you can do various things with them. Now, if I remember correctly, what was it again? Yes, SATCOM and UNATCO underscore 001. If I type in this information, then I will be able to gain access to some of these systems if I don't misspell it anyway. It doesn't take too kindly to that. Okay, UNATCO underscore 001. Log in. There we go. You can often access cameras as well as stationary gun turrets. Now, what we want to do here is unlock that door. There we go. No problems whatsoever. And just so he can't see me, we can turn that camera off. Now, if I was a hacker, I would be able to access that via just simply hacking into it. But you would have a limited amount of time before the system was aware that you were there and would deploy countermeasures, let's just say. Rather unpleasant. Sets alarms off. Electrocutes you. Kind of nasty. There we go, a little bit of experience for exploration. Very nice, an electromagnetic pulse grenade, and that is apparently all that's in here. So, there you go. Entire crate for one little grenade. Must be kind of valuable. If I remember correctly, there's also one stashed around here. There we go. This is a game that rewards exploration and going through various different paths, and I like that an awful lot. Now, I am noticing that this DirectX 10 renderer does seem to up the lighting quite significantly to a point where it's a little bit uncomfortable. We'll make do. It's always nice to get a little bit of extra lighting effect on an engine. This is the Unreal. This isn't even the Unreal Tournament engine, I don't think. Or was it? I don't even think it was that, but it was pretty close nonetheless. Might have been Unreal 1.5. Whatever the case, it did not stand the test of time in terms of looks, let me put it that way. And no matter how many mods and things you apply to it, it is still going to look like ass. Alright, I am rather concerned about this guy. We're going to track him, and then we're going to leg it. As quickly as possible. So I pissed that guy off. I don't want to be shot by him, because it's going to hurt like hell. But I have tranquilized him, so he will eventually fall over. There we go. Just take a little bit of time to do. You can always tell if you've pissed somebody off because the music changes if you ever get in a situation where you're under threat. What you also might want to do is move the bodies out of the way. Sometimes it's actually quite valuable to do that because the NPCs will see the bodies and they will become alert. So we're just going to hide this body back here. It should be fine. Again, the AI is not what I would call especially smart in this game, but it's smart enough. The openness of this level actually freaked a lot of people out when they first played this game, and I absolutely love it. I really do. I think maybe people might be more willing to actually accept something like this now, but when this was released, which was a long ass time ago, you know, this is a decade old, this game. This kind of openness in terms of what looked like a first-person shooter just didn't make a lot of sense to a lot of people. There are so many ways of accessing the different areas. Now, I know for a fact that there's a security belt behind there. Really want to watch out for that.
Be careful. The NSF has set up patchwork security systems here.
Thank you for the information. Right, okay. It's turrets and cameras in the ruins. You can turn them off by typing in SF001. The password is smash the state. I am rather concerned about the presence of that security bot. I do need to get out of there. Oh god, there's a guy around there, isn't there?
The NSF put a commercial-grade security bot in this area. You can either avoid its patrol route or, if you're feeling lucky, try and take it out with the EMP grenades or explosives. I wouldn't recommend taking it on with small arms.
No, I wouldn't either, because it won't work. Now, can we... Where is he? Oh, okay, he's over there. Could easily sneak around here, no problem at all. If I recall correctly, this you can only really get into with lockpicks. You can destroy these things. I could probably blow it up with explosives, but I'm not strong enough to kill it with a baton, so that simply ain't gonna happen. So I cannot gain access to that, and that's okay. Generally speaking, you can't necessarily get everything that's in a level. Again, that's okay. It gives it an awful lot of replayability. Okay, let's not go anywhere near that. That will kill me in about a second, so we don't want to piss that thing off. There was another NSF guy there. Okay, so he's there. Let's see if we can pop him with the trank gun and hide around the corner. Just wait for the invariable few seconds for it to tick its health down, and then it'll eventually fall over. Now, what I am concerned about, of course, is the presence of that security box. I don't actually know where it is. But you can listen out for it. This is the kind of place where quicksaving would probably be a good idea. I can't remember the quicksave keys. It's been a while. It has been a while. Hell, quicksaving is, I'm noticing recently, is becoming less and less popular. Kind of weird, isn't it? That was it. Plus, and there we go. It's more about checkpoints these days. I suppose the consolification of everything. Okay. Okay, NSF around there. And the security bot is probably very close. No, it's okay, right. So which way are we going? Well, want to avoid the patrol route of that. Do I have the prod ready? Maybe. I think I'm out of the security bot's range. I hear an NSF around here. Where is he? There he is. I think not. Thank you very much. And a smack on the head. Get back here. Get back here. Thank you very much. I'll have that. There we go. I'm not going to kill anybody. I refuse. It's just not my style. Now, there's a few thugs down here. I think we're heading down the direction of the dock area. If you so desire, you can shoot the pigeons. I wouldn't recommend it. It's a waste of ammunition. Now, this area, a little bit dangerous. A lot of very open terrain. Is it possible to sneak past? Yeah. If you know what you're doing. Again, it's just worth keeping an eye on their patrol routes. Move as silently as possible. If you're making noise like this, they will hear you. Okay, let's just keep ourselves low, low. I do have the trank gun if need be. Oh god. Thankfully, they do have a fairly small vision cone. Like, for instance, he didn't see me there at all. If I wanted, I'd go zap him, and I think I'll probably do just that. No, you stay right where you are. Thank you. Ah, yes, the prod. Such a great weapon. Now, we have that merc over there. I'll probably just trank him. And yoink. I am not here. I don't know what you are so concerned about.
Keep looking. That's him. He's
no, he's not here. Trust me, he's not. See ya. I'll have whatever you're carrying. Tranquilizer dart. Wonderful. Sometimes you can get some more ammo, and that's so very nice. You'll probably end up with a lot of pistol ammo by the end of this if you do everything in a non-lethal manner. But again, that's the wonderful thing about this game. Technically, you can go through this game and only, I think, kill two people. Yeah, I'm fairly sure there's only two. Actually, is it one? I think it might even be one. Because I'm fairly sure it's possible to avoid one of the guys near the end. So you don't have to really kill anybody but a single dude. Now that is a friendly security bot, so we're not concerned about that. That guy has a sniper rifle, if I remember correctly. And on realistic, that will kill you in one shot. So this is the bit where I always tend to get screwed over on this level. Keep an eye out. I am not here. You cannot see me. In reality, that guy has a much longer range and indeed sight detection than you might expect. I can make a run for those crates, but I'm not particularly happy. If I get all the way over here, he might not be able to see me. Let's hope that that's the case. We'll find out in a moment. No, he's turned his back. Now, I would kind of like that sniper rifle, but there's no point. I have such low rifle skill right now, I might as well wait until later on. It's not like I could actually fire a sniper rifle and really get anything out of it. Okay, the docks. The docks are kind of tricky, because there are at least two or three guys down here.
It all happened an hour ago. The barge docked and the NSF moved right on in, offloading the cargo into speedboats. Our undercover man, Harley Philbin, should be somewhere out on the docks now.
Now, if I recall correctly, there's also a secret under here as well, so I want to keep an eye out for that. So, you could blow up these toxic barrels, which would take them out, but it would also kill them, which is not actually what we're looking to do. So I'll keep an eye on the patrol route. The mercenary's sort of behind there at the moment. He doesn't know that I'm here. I don't believe there's any NSF patrols behind me. Okay. Toggle crouch is kind of handy-dav in this game, and I believe you can enable that via the options. I'm concerned about the presence of the mercenary, who I'm fairly sure was around there too. Oh, sup. Yeah, he's right there. I could trank both and then make a run for it. I don't really like the idea of wasting the ammunition, so what I'm going to do is, like I said, these guys have terrible, terrible cone of fire in terms of their sight. Their actual spotting distance is terrible. I should be able to approach him from this side right here, because he can only see about 90 degrees in front of him. There we go. Sup! Hi, how are you? Oh, what a wonderful evening. Thank you. Unfortunately, that did not bring him down. Hoped it would on a headshot, but there you go.
That's him. He's a cop.
Oh, will you stop? Right, okay, he's hit me with a trank dart. That is not so great. These guys are a lot tougher than the NSF guys. Uh-oh. Right, okay, we successfully tranked him. It's fine. Just need to outrun him for a little while before we get a little bit sneaky. There we go. Took a few bullets, but I'm all right. Again, you're a nano-augmented agent here, so you can endure that kind of thing. But that was a bit of a screw-up on my part. Because I didn't hit him from the back, I did less damage than I otherwise would have with that cattle prod. So we took a little bit of damage. Let's have a look. Is it going to disable any of my abilities? I don't think so. Actually, yeah, fairly heavy damage to the right arm there. So healing-wise, I only have a single med kit. We can get more. I do have this chocolate. The chocolate will actually give you a little bit of healing, not a huge amount, 2 points. Cigarettes, on the other hand, do exactly the opposite, but it's useful to keep a hold of them because they can be traded sometimes. So what I'll probably do is I'll use that on the right arm because I don't want my accuracy damaged too much. There we go. I could heal about 60 points with the skill in medic that I currently have. So aside from that, that is the dock pretty much clear. And I believe there's another medkit over here. And an accursed pigeon. Off you go. Now, this bomb they were talking about, Harley Philbin, is down here. So you can talk to him to get some interesting information. And if I recall correctly, down under here, there is a secret. Let's go and have a look-see. There we go. Now, I don't have good swimming skill, so this makes this actually kind of difficult. I don't know if there's a rebreather around here, but... Right, yeah, that will take 2 lockpicks to get through, or I can blow it up with an explosive, assuming I can get my hands on one. That, indeed, could also be quite tricky. Bear in mind that you can very easily die from drowning in this game, so it's something to just keep an eye on. We'll have a drink of that. There we go. That also gets you 2 points of health. No complaints there. Sup?
About time you showed up.
Iron and copper. The statue is copper on an iron frame, right?
Password's enough, pal. Don't think you know something about the lady I don't. My dad did tours out here.
I heard that you can get me inside.
Depends. You get your man out, take back the statue, whatever. But I know the commander and I don't want to see him get hurt. Here's a picture so you don't make a mistake.
You are the ugliest man in video games. Yes.
You can trust me.
I'll take your word. Here's the key to the front entrance. Commander's not much of a soldier. He'll surrender as soon as he sees you. I need him alive because he's my main contact at the NSF. If he's dead, I don't have much of a business.
Thanks.
Indeed. You can kill him if you desire. Hell, I could kill this guy right now if I wanted. In fact, let's do that. Let's do that right now. We're going to save it and we can quick load afterwards. If I were to shoot Harley Philbin in the head... What? He's a collaborator. Unfortunately, it seems Harley Philbin can take an awful lot of damage. Why will you not die, Harley? Harley, come on. Really? Really, Harley? Well, looks like you can't actually kill Harley Philbin. I admittedly never tried. Can we zap Harley Philbin? So he can take 5 cattle prods, at least 50 bullets. Guy's a bit of a hard ass, as you can quite clearly see. It's a shot to the head. Most of the NPCs in this game can be killed. Apparently, Harley Philbin is not one of them. Alright. We need to quick load, and I can't remember the key for it. Yes, there we go. Quick load. Slash. Yes, I would love to. Fantastic. We will not try to kill Harley Philbin. Thank you very much.
How do you know so much about the commander?
He's my main contact in the NSF. I need him alive and out on bail.
UNATCO will probably keep him in custody.
At least he has a chance if he's alive. I warned him, you know. I said right to his face, don't take weapons into the lady. That makes you as bad as UNATCO.
Don't forget, it was the NSF that C4'd the statue in the first place. UNATCO's here to put the pieces back together.
Ask me, I think the government did it. They want people to think the NSF are terrorists.
Yes. This game is about conspiracies, if you hadn't already figured it out. Ooh, ship's wheel. Yay. You know, back at the time when this was released, that was actually really, really cool. Not so much now, sadly. Flares, always nice to have for distractions. Combat knife, I think we already have one of those, so... I don't think we really need the crowbar. We can just get rid of that completely. There we go, we have a combat knife.
You with Philbin?
I get a cut for bringing him over.
Tell me what you know about the NSF operation.
I'm not that high level. The more elite troops, they're the ones that took over the ship and unloaded it into speedboats. I think we're supposed to be a diversion.
A ship?
That's all I know. The commander gave me a 10mm clip, a box of 30-06 ammo, and some crossbow darts, and said keep your head down. Like I'm gonna take on your NATCO troops. Wanna? You can have the clip for 175, the 30-06 for 300, and the darts for 50. But if I was you, I'd avoid a hit.
Yeah. So, again, always nice to get the ability to buy some stuff.
The whole reason my neighborhood turned into a war zone. Somebody should stick him full of these things like a roast pig.
Yeah, we're not gonna do that. But whatever the case, it's always nice to talk to characters in this game because they will generally give you some nice information. And as I said before, there are so many ways of doing this first level right here that it is handy to have. Now, you know I was mentioning earlier about blowing open that secret? Well, there's a crate of TNT here that could prove handy. We don't really need to use lockpicks to take that out when we can, in fact, use a crate of TNT. We have to be a little bit careful with this. If you drop this from too high a height, it will actually explode and kill you. So, over we go. This one first level, I think, aside from this being the best game ever made, this is also one of the best levels ever made, if not the best, because of just how many options it really has. You can do so, so much with it. Now, the main problem with this is the fact that TNT doesn't really... Yeah. So... Evidently, we cannot, or can we? See, you can actually push it down. There we go. You think, oh, you know, Totalbiscuit doesn't know what he's doing? Of course he does. He knows exactly what he's doing. He doesn't really. Come on. Come on. Come on. Is it going down? Is it going down? Very, very slowly, yes. Come on. There we go. That's what I'm talking. Oh, God, I'm drowning. I'm drowning. I'm drowning. Get to. Yes. Please do not forget about your O2 level. This is the Scottish way of dealing with things if you want to be a bit tight-fisted with your lockpicks. Now I've offended a small part of my demographic. Up we go again. I just love the fact you can even do this. This game was full of what is now being coined as a phrase as emergent gameplay, which is stuff that they didn't actually expect you to do, but you could do anyway because the game was designed around the idea of allowing you a certain degree of freedom. So sometimes you could do things that the game did not expect. Like, for instance, people found out that you could use the grenades, the landmines, as a sort of stepladder. You could actually place them, you could stand on these things because they were large enough, and the game allowed you to do that. And the game didn't stop you with invisible walls or anything like that. If you could climb over an area, you could climb over an area. Generally speaking, you were not restricted. The water effects in this game sucked, as you can also tell. Now, is it close enough? Is it close enough? I'm not convinced. I want it to be just a little bit closer. Don't have much in terms of O2 left, and I want to be careful because I don't actually want to kill myself down here. Right, that should be close enough. We'll go once again, and then we shall fire a pistol round all the way down and hopefully not kill ourselves. Let's quick save and make sure that doesn't happen. Now, the weapon does not work underwater. I forgot about that. What I can do, if I remember correctly, is shoot it from the dock. Is that floating upwards again? Oh, God. Come on. I know I can do this. I'm sure I've done this before. I'm not going to look like a fool in front of my damn audience. Down we go. Down we go. If Human Revolution allows you to do even half of what this game does with a modern physics engine, I will be very pleased. So the physics engine in this game was extremely rudimentary, but quite amazing for the time. Extremely impressive. And it allowed for all these things that you just wouldn't have otherwise expected in another game. I'm hoping that is far enough, because it's going to start floating up a little bit. I think I can target it underwater, if I remember correctly. I certainly hope so. Can I do it? Yes, I can. Is it close enough? I hope so. Yes, indeed, folks. The shrapnel hit me from there. Well, there you go. That, I believe, blew through here. Yes, it did. Thank you very much. And there we go. We better turn the light on here. I actually see it. Now, this is a bit dangerous. Gonna have to be pretty quick with it. It's just great that this is even here. I mean, I bet 98% of players had no idea, because you can't see under the water in this game, because barely anyway. You just wouldn't have even noticed that it was there. I don't believe there's any indication of it, but it is, and it's right here. So, and you can get some neat stuff out of it in the process, mods primarily. But you got to be careful, because if you go under here without that, is there a rebreather in here? No, there is a sawn-off shotgun, however. Right, careful. Up, up, up. Whoa, okay, okay. Very low in HP. Heal the torso. Heal the drowning. Heal the drowning. Up, 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 up. Quickly. There we go. I think we got everything, as far as I'm aware. Sawn-off shotgun actually counts as a rifle, so we're probably not going to use it. But whatever, there you go. Yep, that is everything inside the ship. But two weapon modifications, definitely worth going down there for. So wonderful that it's even there. Okay. Very cool. So, we'll have a look at modding our weapons. I'd like to do a couple of modifications to the mini crossbow. Now, the light does take bioenergy, so you don't want to waste too much of that. Okay, let's have a look and see what we have. Accuracy and reload. There are only a certain number of mods you can put on any weapon, but I'm going to put this one on here. There we go. A little bit extra accuracy. Always good. Probably put reload in that as well, actually, because the reload time for that's kind of lousy. There we go. Awesome. Fabulous. And that sawn-off shotgun. We'll put it in there just in case we need a lethal method. If you get very, very close with this thing, it does hurt like hell. But if you notice, the accuracy, because I'm untrained in rifles, is awful. Really, really bad. It is more of an RPG than an FPS. Doesn't matter. It's like, oh, twitch aim. Oh, iron sights. No, not in this game. There are sight options. You can actually add sights to weapons, although they don't change the way that the weapon looks. But you can do it. Right. Well, that's the docks area dealt with. Let us continue. Now, remember, that security bot is friendly. We're not going to do anything with that. The guy with the sniper rifle all the way over there, I don't want to engage him because he'll probably one-shot me. He has a tendency of doing that. You can catch him from behind, certainly, but it's still a little bit risky. So, since I don't really need a sniper rifle right now, we're going to avoid that entirely. Now, around here, there is another area which is accessible, which will give you a wide variety of nice things. I want to take this guy out first, though, before we do anything. Because I'd like to get quite close to those NSF. Make sure that I have... Yes, he did spot me, but it's okay. Should be able to get around the corner before he's able to get in range. Like I said, these basic NSF troops are very, very easy to deal with. There we go. Thank you for my trank dart back. Excellent stuff. That is why the tranquilizer darts are some of the most powerful weapons in the game, because they can... With normal grunts, they can take them out in one hit, regardless of where you hit them, but it just takes a while to bring them down. So in the meantime, they might alert other people. Now, those three over there, we will engage eventually, but I'm going to go in here first. Now, if I remember correctly, there's also another guy in here. Might want to watch out for him. Yes, indeed, there is. Lean out. Little shot, and in the corner. Did I hit him? Yes, I did. Good. Good. All over. Thank you very much. Right. A hazmat suit. Not exactly common in terms of when you find them in the game, and not all that useful either.
This power box must have been damaged in the raid. Don't cross through the arcs. I'm also picking up an EMP field here. If you're not careful, it'll suck away your bioelectrical energy.
Now, we could bypass this with a multi-tool if we so desired, but I have a better idea. Once again, make use of the way that the terrain is designed. And the game is designed not to stop you from doing stuff like this. So, let's have a look. Let's have a look at what we can do here. So, I notice that there is a button next to a forklift. Now, I could make use of this. Can I get up here, though? No, I can't quite jump high enough. But I believe I can maybe jump onto the electrical box. There we go, I can. There we go. Will it let me up? Nope. No, it will not. I cannot quite jump high enough. There are abilities later in the game that allow you to jump higher. Let's not stand in that. That is a bad idea. It's going to do a lot of damage, and it's going to suck away my bioelectrical energy. However, what we shall do is we're going to Come on, get up there. Fine, I'll just throw it through the arc. That's a terrible place to leave it. Okay, can I get close enough? Can I get close enough? Only just. There we go. That should be good enough. A little bit of damage, nothing to really worry about. Pop this button. Pop. Oh, right, I managed to kill myself. Nice. Nicely done, Totalbiscuit. Nicely done. Managed to run into the arcs and immediately die, by the looks of it. Let's try that one again, shall we? No one ever said this game would be easy, only that it would be worth it. Come on. On we go. Use the forklift to make our way over here. There is another crate there, so that's not too bad. Should easily be able to get back, if need be. There we go. And an exploration skill point bonus. Fabulous. That's what I always wanted. Now, do I have enough skill points to actually get anything? Short answer, not really. Nothing that I really want now, anyway. Patience is a virtue in this game. I want to add two. That'll give me a clip mortar. The fact that this first level can take this long if you decide to explore everywhere is great. I love that. And a lot of these levels are like that. There's a lot of very, very open levels. Ah, laser sight. These are great. Love it. Absolutely love it. Clip size I can't put on that, but I can activate a laser sight on that, which makes aiming with that much easier. And we'll put a ammo count on the pistol, just in case we actually need to use that. Past the first three levels, which is a problem that I do have with this game, you might wonder why exactly I am deliberately being non-lethal. Yeah, I'm being a bit of a pacifist. Because you are actually, not only do you get complimented for that at the end of this level, but you then get told off by another guy. So it does affect you. But past about the first three levels, they don't really comment on your effectiveness anymore. Is there something over here? Yes, there is. There you go. Always good to look for absolutely everything in this game. Now, I do have the laser sight. That can be activated by pressing this button right here. Generally speaking, they don't spot the laser sight, so you don't really have to worry about that, but it will give you a little bit better accuracy at range. Just watch where the laser sight goes and you'll be good. Now, if we sneak around here, there will actually be a very cool conversation. And there's an awful lot of discussion between NPCs. Actually, is it those NPCs over there? I think it might be. So, bearing in mind, NPCs have an absolutely abysmal sight range in this game. We're just going to go a little bit of sneaky around here. No problem at all. And hopefully we can speak to them. Don't want to bring this guy down. He's a little bit too close to his compadres there. I'm not too keen on it. Plus the effective range of this crossbow, as you can see, I'm not actually within the effective range. So the chances of me hitting him from there are fairly low. It's doable, but it's a little tricky. Am I outside of his sight range? I believe so. It's very dark, ladies and gentlemen. This entire game is done at night. I don't know why either. It just is. It's just, you know, the sky's been scorched by horrible events or whatever, but yeah. If we sneak around here, I believe they will have something to say. Please be right. Can't see me. Cannot see me. You have the FOV of a Call of Duty player. You're not going to speak, are you? Oh, disappointed. They usually have a conversation. How very irritating. I guess they're not going to have a conversation if I shoot them in the face, are they? We could do that. If we so desire. The thing is, there's no point. Will they have enough ammo to replenish this crossbow dart I'm going to use on them? Well, one way to find out, I guess.
I know I heard.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Not quite what I had in mind. It's okay. They have really bad sight range. They can't see me. I am not here. Aha! Sup? Bye. I love this weapon. Even is the shell cartridges on the ground, which, to be fair, for a game of this age, is fairly reasonable. Right. Well, if you're not going to have a conversation, you are of no use to me. These guys over here, we can take them out if we like. We've got enough ammo. Might as well. Fairly difficult to approach with melee weapons because they're facing in different directions, but not impossible. I do have a full clip of cattle prod that I can use. Can he see me from here? Probably not. Can he hear me? Maybe. I could probably attack them. I'm just more concerned about that guy over there. We need to sort of take him out at the fullest possible extent of... Yeah, there we go. Oh, I missed him with the prod. Missed him with the prod. Ah! Okay, so he's stunned. Need to bring him down quickly before the prod wears off. There we go. If I had any other problems with this game, and I do have plenty, and that's the thing, this game does have quite a lot of warts. For instance, aiming and actually hitting somebody with a melee weapon, the swing is surprisingly small. So often you will actually miss and you don't really mean to. Okay, we're fine. We took a hit. Not really a big deal. Now, if we so desired, we could go down into the bottom, or we can use these shipping crates to get up to the top. As it turns out, we're probably going to go and do both, because it's just fun that way. You can avoid all of the fighting on the ground floor if you want. But where's the fun in that? Alright. Use a few crates here and there. Make our way over here. There we go. I think this video is just going to be the first level, and I think that's probably appropriate, because this level signifies everything that's so great about this game, and the way that it's actually designed. Let's not indeed go into the many, many other great things about it. For instance, the fact that it has a great plot. It might seem a little bit stilted by today's standards, but by the standards of a decade ago, the plot was excellent. You know, there are a couple of games I can think that match it, Planescape Torment being one of them, but seriously, such a great plot. Conspiracy theories, all manner of crazy stuff going on. Yeah, you could make a movie out of it. You could absolutely make a movie out of it. And it would probably suck because you Ball would get the rights or whatever. Oh, whatever the case, you could very easily make a movie out of this and it would be great. It really would. At least in terms of the plot and if they pulled it off properly. Now I'm a little bit injured. It's going to impede my movement just slightly. I'll keep using the prod here. If you get enough strength add-ons, you can actually use the baton in a more effective way because it will do enough damage to simply knock them out immediately. Right now I don't have the strength for it. He's got a crossbow. He's going to turn around in a minute, isn't he? He's going to turn around. Don't turn around. Don't turn around. Oh, stop. Oh, thank God for your terrible sight. Should have gone to Specsavers. Okay, we've got a guy over here. Two guys, in fact. TNT crates are very useful for killing them if you want to kill them. We don't. We have no desire to do so. And I've forgotten what the reload button is. It's not your usual keys. It's been so long. So very long. Yes, semicolon is the reload key. It made sense. It does. It actually makes more sense than you might think. Turn on the laser sight. Be a kind of a long range shot, but it's doable. I'll probably piss off the guy that who's next to. That's a cow. Hello. Come around the corner, please, so that I can zap you with this one. No! This one's brutal! Yes, that's realistic for you, folks. They hit you in the head, you're gone. You are gone. Unfortunately, I don't remember when my last save point was. Oh, it was right back here. That's a bit annoying, isn't it? But it's okay. We can very, very easily get back to that point. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Realistic is difficult. It looks great when you're sneaking around and bringing people down, but if they do spot you, you're probably boned. Initially, anyway. Once you get all your augmentations, you become a little bit more durable, but then again, so do the enemy. Right, well, that was not amazing. I looked like an idiot. These are the two things we need to grab. Could run back through there, that seems kind of pointless. I could lift the crate and jump on the crate, and then blow up the crate. It works. We'll avoid all of the combat because, hey, you've seen that before. Yeah, I love that. Thank you. There we go. A distinct lack of medkits in this area is not helping matters. It never did. Always about conservation of resources, this game, as well. Being very, very careful. The amount of cash that you can gain in this game is completely finite. Like, you will not find cash drops on people, usually. There are a certain number of credit cards within the game that you can pick up, and there are a certain number of ATMs that you can hack, and that is it. However, there are no vendors in this game either. Everything is bought via conversation, so they worked out what you could afford and what you couldn't. If you wanted to afford everything, then you needed to be very, very careful with what you spent, and indeed, what you managed to collect. You had to know where everything was. You had to explore. That's what this game rewards. Exploration and some outside-of-the-box thinking. Now, kind of got boned by those guys, so... wasn't too happy about that, but... I could probably just charge this guy. But I'm not going to do that, because that just seems silly after what happened to me the last time. So, we'll trank him. And we'll run. Fall over right about now. There we go. Now this other guy needs to be brought down as well. Activate the laser sight. Oh, we haven't activated the laser sight at all. There we go. Drag and drag. Okay, now I have the laser sight. Can we hit him from here? Probably not. Am I going to try anyway? Probably. There you go. You can do it outside of the effective range. It's just kind of risky. As it turns out... Are you going down or not? Huh.
A shame, isn't it? The French terrorist group Silhouette claims that France was wrong to give the U.S. the statue. We think they planned the bombing.
Later on in the game, you find out a lot of different things about that. Patience is a virtue. Running away, also a virtue. And do be careful not to get within the way of the bullet and that TNT crate. Things tend to get a little bit unpleasant. Are you going down yet? There we go. You're fine. Have a little snooze. And yes, we'll have your tranquilizer darts as well. Pretty slow progress. You can actually go through this game, at least later on anyway, or certainly in the lower difficulty levels, just playing it kind of like a shooter, but it's not really the way the game was designed to work. It's a game about espionage, sneaking around, stealth, as well as a little bit of gun-on-gun action when need be. But it is about planning your attacks and being very, very careful with how you do particular things. Okay. Do I want to heal the torso? Not yet. I can probably sustain another... light hit there, so I'm not too worried about it. Now we can avoid these guys entirely. This will get me all the way to the top of the statue. However, bear in mind there was a secondary objective for this. And if I don't do the secondary objective, then it's alright, you don't lose the game, but you lose an option of experience, and you will actually get told off by the person in question, so we will most likely go inside. And we'll actually work our way down, which is doable. A little risky, but doable. Now, grenades. These are placed as landmines. You can grab them if you are very quick. If you are not, well, you kind of explode. Okay. And there is an NSF terrorist around here as well, just to make matters a little bit more interesting. Thank you. I believe there's another one around here. Oh, hi! Now... if I am very good, I could probably detonate the grenade on there. It will take a little bit of sneaking. I think we need to get around the other side if we're going to do that. That gas grenade is non-lethal, so I could use that in order to take them out. Can't see me. Can't see me. Assuming there is a gas grenade in that wall. I don't think there is, actually, is there? Okay, well, there is another approach we can use. Alright, let's use this landmine ability, shall we? I'm gonna plonk that there. And what I'm gonna do is I am going to draw them in this direction. Bullet's usually a good way to do it. Come on, through you come. Detonate the gas grenade. This may knock him out, I'm not entirely sure. I don't really want to go within range of the gas, because that will actually do damage to me as well. Not what I would call ideal, but I can use this as an opportunity, if I wish, to sneak down the stairs. Or go up the stairs. Going up the stairs will take me to the primary objective. Going down the stairs will take me to the secondary. Will it knock him out? It might. I can't actually remember. Now, there's a camera down here. I can hear it. Something to look out for. That didn't knock him out, did it? Oh dear. They might stop pursuing me. Maybe. Nope. Okay. Yep. Looks like they've stopped. Cool. All they saw was a bullet and a little bit of gas. Now, this is problematic. Looks like they're coming after me again. Sub!
Big guy. He can't hide for long.
No, but I can catapult you in the face if need be. I think the thug survived it, and I'm fairly sure the NSF terrorist at the top got knocked out completely. If that's the case, we should go and check. Make sure he's not there anymore. I don't know, I hear footsteps. I think he's still around. Unbelievably. And I'm running very low on cattle prod.
I swear I heard something.
Oh, hi. Yeah, he's bleeding a bit. He has no HP. We'll just do that. Alright, I'm on my last clip of cattle prod, folks. It is dire. It is dire. Now, I am concerned about what's down the bottom of those stairs, because I know I hear a camera, and I'm fairly sure there is a... Yeah, I'm almost certain there's a sentry gun here. Let's be careful. Where is the camera? Cameras aren't quite as restricted as the normal guys in terms of the size of their sight ratio. Careful. Careful. However, there is a TNT crate here we could use. If there's anything unpleasant that needs to be detonated. We're going to keep going downstairs, I think, because there's nothing we want to deal with down there yet. Now, this area is extremely dangerous. That is what I'm concerned about. If the camera spots me, that sentry gun will kill me. However, if you remember correctly, there was a TNT crate. We could use that TNT crate to detonate sentry gun. Let's be very careful about that. Ooh, hi. Now, if there's an explosion here, this is going to cause a few problems. Gotta be a little bit careful. Now, what I want to try and do is, if I take out all the guys in this room, if I detonate that gas barrel, that will probably stun them for long enough to hopefully take out the sentry turret, and then we can trank them. One guy up there, which is outside of my range, and there'll be that guy there, so we'll be very quick. Now, I need to be really quick to get out of the way of that. There we go. Right, that didn't detonate. Good. Will when I shoot at it. I need to be as far away as possible. This is going to hurt one way or the other. The shrapnel will probably hit me. You know, I think I might have annoyed him a little bit. Please don't tell me. He's going for the alarm, isn't he? Nobody here but us chickens. He shouldn't be able to get to the alarm before he falls over. I hope. As far as I'm aware, nobody else knows that that happened. Awesome. And we'll have the lockpick that was in that crate. Which, inexplicably, did not get destroyed by the TNT explosion. Don't ask me why. Hitting him from here is going to be tricky. Got him. Yeah, as you can tell, I did used to play an awful lot of this game. I've beaten it probably about 8 times. There are 3 different endings. Although there are a variety of things that can happen within the game that do change quite dramatically depending on what you do in your playthroughs. And that's probably one of the best things about it. Right. Okay. Are we empty? Are we sorted out? I hear footsteps. From which direction? I think they're in that guard room. If I remember correctly. What I also know is that there is a medkit in here somewhere and I could definitely use it. Caution, caution, caution.
I think Gunther is being held behind this laser-triggered alarm. If you don't want to set off the alarm, you can either hack the control panel in the doorway or find a way around. My blueprint of the statue shows a few air shafts.
Yes. You can indeed use those air shafts. Bear in mind that the game will sort of give you less and less guidance as you go along. This is very much sort of the tutorial level, trying to show you, you know, this is what Deus Ex is all about. This is what it does. This is what you can do. And then later on, you'll just be expected to know and to look for different opportunities. And yes, if I repeatedly spam this right here, which is actually a sprite, you can even sort of see it against the wall. It's a rotating square, but it's going to, nonetheless, you'll actually regain HP from repeatedly spam clicking this thing. Although I think you actually managed to run out to the water fountain, which is fairly impressive, honestly. That's a pretty crappy water fountain. Whatever the case, got about 15-20 HP from that, so you can't really complain. Now, if we go up to the top level here. Yes, you can drink beer. Yes, it will get you drunk, but you will gain some HP back from it. I think there's a crate over here with another medkit. There we go. Fantastic. What is the PS20, you ask? The PS20 is kind of useless. It is a one-shot plasma weapon. It does a lot of damage, but that's pretty much all it does. It's kind of handy to have one, though, if you wanted to take out a very high-value and tough target, because these things do hit for, like, 31, which is quite nasty, and they do have a base accuracy of 100. So if you're getting really close, you can probably one-shot somebody with it, if you know what you're doing. Right, let's keep those closed, because we know the security bots out there. Now, I am rather concerned about this. I believe I can avoid most of the security by going through the vents, if I remember correctly.
This security setup is strictly amateur stuff. Keep an eye out for ways to bypass it. These old pre-millennial buildings are riddled with ventilation shafts and maintenance tunnels.
Also riddled with horrible, horrible textures as a direct result of the very, very old engine. A lot of the game looks like this, folks. If you can get past that, you will enjoy this game immensely. Some people are completely turned off by it. I do not blame them. But trust me, you really should give it a shot. If you've never played it before, you are missing out. Ah, soy food. It is delicious. It'll give us 5 HP, if I remember correctly. Now, I can make my way through here. If I blow that door up, that's going to be problematic, but I can keep going around, and I think there's another way in. I could, of course, pick the lock. I'm just trying to conserve resources right now. Careful. There might be somebody in here. There is not at the moment. Another PS20. We can only have one of those at any given time. That's why they're kind of so useless. Oh, look. Nice. The account number for that. We can steal from it if we like, and that will actually go into your notes and we can look at it later. But you will have to type it in manually nonetheless. Now if I don't think you can get over this, but you can take a shot from here. I don't know if it'll kill him before the alarm goes off. That's my main concern. If I gas him, it won't kill him either. As far as I know. But if he gets to the end of his patrol, does he get this far? No, he doesn't. Okay, problem. Can we disable him from here? Maybe. Just maybe. Patience.
I swear I heard
something. Oh, Christ. Hopefully, he won't know we're here. That's running. That's not good. Has he decided we're not here?
Is someone there?
Nope. Nobody here. No one whatsoever. Keep going about your business like nothing happened. Ooh, didn't alert him. If we did alert him, then it would be alarm time, and that's not a good thing. Very difficult to lose aggro if there's an alarm going on. Now, if I break my way through here, I'll use one of these lockpicks. I've got 3 of them. I should be all right. Just don't ask. I know. You can't even see the lock. It's fine. Trust me. It's an old game. A little bit cautious about this. Okay, he's over there. Can't see me. Can't see me. Can see me. Can see me. Oh god. That's alerted everybody, hasn't it? Pretty much.
That's him. He's a cop.
Yeah, I know. I know. That's the alarm. That's the alarm. Leave immediately. Gas grenade on the way out will certainly help matters. Hope he doesn't come around the corner before he falls over. Hope he doesn't come around the corner before he falls over. Oh! One shot in the head. One shot in the head. If you screw up in this game, things will go very wrong for you very quickly. I don't remember when the last quick load was. Oh yes, it was here, wasn't it? Would you like me to take a more violent approach? Perhaps you would. Because, of course, there are other ways of doing this. We'll take an opportunity to find exactly what they are. So, that TNT crate has now disappeared. Callus sucks.
I think we've got an answer. He's a cop.
Okay, only hit me in the arm. I'm alright. At that range, it's very likely it'll hit you in the head, but... Oh, God. Right, yeah, stay out of the way of him. Oh yeah, there's the TNT, great. Okay. I dealt with that. So I've kind of pissed him off. Should be able to prod him when he comes around the corner, hopefully. If I do it right. As long as he decides not to go for the alarm instead, which he could.
I could swear I heard something.
Nah, he didn't hear anything. Thank you. So, gas canister there we could use. And take a more direct route into the prison cell, if we so desired. Did I get him? Yes, I did. Wait for him to fall over, and then I'll show you another way of getting through. What use is the alarm if everyone inside is already dead? Let's find out, shall we?
I think Gunther is being held behind this laser-triggered alarm. If you don't want to set off the alarm, you can either hack the control panel in the doorway or find a way around. My blueprint of the statue shows a few air shafts.
It's not the only thing you can do. If I recall correctly, we can also blow up the laser trap if we do it properly. Throwing these things is kind of risky, if I'm totally honest. Okay.
I think we got cops.
No cops here.
This security setup is strictly amateur stuff. Keep an eye out for ways to bypass it. These old pre-millennial buildings are riddled with ventilation shafts and maintenance tunnels.
Big guy.
Oh!
This guy wasn't just a grunt.
Okay, think about it a little bit more. Consider it. It's not about overthinking it, it's about making sure you think about it just right. Now, the detonation will also detonate that gas grenade. We can also make sure that it detonates something a little bigger. I believe I can push this, or can I? Do I actually have the strength? I do. Oh, God. Not as much strength as I would like, so let's just ignore that for the time being. If I throw the TNT around there, I should be able to detonate the alarm panel. That might have been slight overkill. Oh dear, what a mess. So much for that non-lethal run, eh? He got in the way. It wasn't my fault. Wow. I think the explosion plus the damage that dude should kill him, in theory. Fix ourselves up a little bit, wait for the gas to dissipate. Well, it dealt with the laser-triggered alarm system. There is no laser-triggered alarm system. Not anymore. Yes, choke on the gas, you idiot.
This guy's a cop.
Yes, quite. I think not. Should bring him down. I don't think there's any alarm panel for him to go for anymore. I'm fairly sure I blew it up. There's a camera in here, isn't there?
One of our top agents.
Where the hell's the camera? I can hear it. Well, whatever. Oh, Christ, it's there. Right. Okay. So, if that camera registers me for too long, that sentry gun will kill me. How do we deal with it? Well, I don't think shooting it with a sawn-off shotgun is going to do the job. I could, however, bypass it with a multi-tool. If you get armor-piercing rounds, you can actually blow up things like that with a shotgun. Very handy to have, but we don't have any AP rounds, so there we go. Camera has been bypassed. And an accuracy modification, which we will add, once again, to the crossbow. There we go. Much better.
Agent, open the door.
Yes, I would like to. Unfortunately, I'm... How did this get here? I am not good with computers. It probably is that old one, isn't it? What was it? NSF_001 password smash the state... maybe not. Okay, let's look at our notes and find out exactly what it was. I think it's the same one. Oh, yes, NSF001, not underscore. Okay, that'll be why. State. There we go. We can open that. And the camera is disabled. Fantastic. Hi, hi.
Glad you're not hurt, Agent.
Command should not have left us to be surrounded.
Risk is part of the job. I think you lucked out this time.
Agent Navarra and I were ready to go in, but for no reasons I said pull back. I do not retreat. Please give me a weapon and move out of the way.
No. Absolutely not. Pissing Gunther off is okay, by the way. I don't like him anyway, he's a bit of a douche.
First thing is to get you out of here. I'll handle the enemy.
Excuse that I have forgotten your brother Paul Denton and the infinite power of nano-augmentation.
I just can't spare any arms. Please retreat to a safe location.
Go ahead. Advance up the stairs to the command center at the top. I will take my rusty metal bones and sweep away into the junk pile.
Yeah, I'm so upset. I will go to cry now. He's not happy, folks. Not happy at all.
Now I see the reason for the pullback. They wanted to show off their new nano-augmentation technology.
Quite. Right, well, that's a secondary objective done. Means if I recall correctly, we do get the skill points for that. If I wanted to get something, it would probably be computers. Always useful to have a bit of training in those, and then we can do a little bit of hacking. I can show you how that works, actually. If you click hack, it'll initialize this hacking tool right here. And then you've got a very limited amount of time in order to access the system. If you stay in for too long, then you will run into a situation where it sets off alarms and all sorts of things. I don't have the ability to control turrets because I'm not high enough level in that, but yeah, you can do a lot of things. Right, so we need to head up to the top then. See what we can find. I don't know how many more of those guys are actually alive. But we do want to stay out of their way, nonetheless. I'm fairly sure I took out both of the guards at the top, but I can't be certain. There might be two more. In which case, a gas grenade is usually the best way to deal with them. Nice narrow spaces. And then just hit them with a couple of bolts as well from the crossbow. Because if they're mercenaries, they're going to be tougher than the usual NSF guys.
Gunther has re-established contact. He says you helped him escape. Good work.
Yes. All the way to the top, folks. All the way.
The NSF targeted a shipment of the plague vaccine Ambrosia. We can't locate it. See if the leader will surrender when you reach the command post. We'd like to interrogate him.
Hopefully he will. I think there are actually two more up here. There might be. Can't quite remember. Are they here?
Let's get out of here.
I'm standing my ground.
They sprung Herman. We don't stand a chance against a mech.
This is it, Private. We knew it might come to this.
What good are we to the NSF if we end up dead?
If you NADCO breach the perimeter, then it's already too late. Get ready to fight.
Not much of an emotion for these guys, is there? But it's okay. Can we do two bolts in rapid succession, then retreat down the stairs? Maybe.
They found him. He's a cop.
Took a hit on the arm. Nothing, and I really need to worry about that. They will be down before you know it. I am the pacifist mech, ladies and gentlemen. Well, the pacifist nano-org, at any rate. You don't have to worry for your safety. Although you might get beaten in jail later, or possibly even set on fire. Right. Again, that PS20. It's just so pointless. What a wonderful, wonderful view. The actual view distance in this game is better than World of Warcraft. Unbelievably. You can see all the way down there. Hell, if I had a sniper rifle, I could probably even hit him from here. We're not going to be doing anything like that. Okay, up to the top. I'm fairly sure that's the last set of guards.
Easy. We want you to take this one alive and conscious. Find out what you can about the shipment, then turn him over to one of the troopers.
Greetings. I could knock him out, but I'm not going to do that.
Don't shoot.
Not yet, anyway.
I surrender.
So you think you know better than FEMA what to do with this month's Ambrosia shipment?
You're too late. It's on its way back to the people, and you can't do a damn thing about it.
Tell me about the shipment, and I'll order the troops to pick you up as a prisoner instead of a corpse.
Ask away. We already won this round.
Where are you taking it?
We're just giving ordinary people the same chance to survive as the bureaucrats in Washington.
You'll have to unload New York because the choppers would spot you at sea.
I think the government made the plague on purpose to get rid of the population growth.
Pass on your orders to the troopers. Report back to base on the west side of the island. Mission complete.
Just answer the question.
Don't believe me? It's all in the numbers. For 100 years, there's been a conspiracy of plutocrats against ordinary people.
You have a single fact to back that up.
Number one. In 1945, corporations paid 50% of federal taxes. Now they pay about 5%. Number two. In 1900... 90% of Americans were self-employed. Now it's about 2%.
So,
It's called consolidation. Strengthen governments and corporations, weaken individuals. With taxes, this can be done imperceptibly over time.
They didn't really have a huge number of very good voice actors, as you can tell. A lot of these were actually guys from the studio. There are no famous names in this game as far as I'm aware at all.
I guarantee you that the interrogation staff at UNATCO will not be as forbearing as I am.
Yeah, the secret police. You're just bullies for a completely illegitimate government in Washington.
We will locate that shipment one way or another.
The entire executive branch is handpicked. 19 of the last 23 U.S. presidents have been members of the Trilateral Commission. The Trilateral Commission is financed by the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds. Don't tell me.
That's a think tank. Anyone can become a member.
But not everyone does. That's why they call it the secret government.
Yes, conspiracy theories abound, folks.
You can't fight ideas with bullets.
Some Da Vinci stuff right here. Now, if I recall correctly, you can do that, which will get you shot, but if you do it right, you can actually knock this guy out. Now, I'm fairly sure you'll get, like, told off for it later.
She finally let us loose. We were right behind you and cut through them like a hot knife through butter.
Regardless of the fact that there were barely any there to begin with, because I dealt with all of them. Run! Please don't kill me. Please don't kill me. He shot my arm off! God damn it! Let's hope he can't climb ladders. He is a little fat, after all.
That's over the line. What did I just tell you? We won already. Report back to base.
The chief finally let us loose. We were right behind you and cut through them like a hot knife through butter.
It's not over the line. It's hilarious. I don't know what you're talking about. What a goddamn whiner. Back to base, ladies and gentlemen, to experience one of the best themes in video games ever. Oh, yes. I keep coming back to this game every now and again. It gets reinstalled. It's one of the two games on the internet that have the when someone mentions it, someone must reinstall it mantra. One of them is Deus Ex, and the other one is Oblivion. The difference with Deus Ex and Oblivion is that someone will install it and actually play it, as opposed to Oblivion, whereby they will install it, spend 2 days modding it, and then never actually play the game. I have experienced this many times. It is simply the truth. I would not lie to you. Grab these two things while we're here. Very nice indeed, yes. It's what we want, it's what we need. And all the way back to the UNATCO headquarters. The trees look better than the ones in WoW. That is disturbing to me. It really, really is. It's a sad state of affairs, folks.
They sent us in to pick up the pieces. We've already searched the bodies and delivered the enemy munitions.
Yep, thankfully I grabbed most of them before you did that. Always a good thing. I also might even have the cash to buy that scope eventually.
We've got the island secured. How did things look in the statue?
The leader surrendered. So they were after Ambrosia.
Month's supply for the East Coast. We think they've taken it back to the city.
I didn't know UNATCO handled the Ambrosia distribution.
Manderly will brief us shortly. UNATCO makes sure the limited supply of vaccine gets to government agencies and key industries.
It's good to finally see some action.
Yeah, well, get your ass inside. The briefing will be in Manderly's office, level 2.
Is he cross with me? I didn't, like, kill anybody, if I remember correctly. It's just that one guy with the explosive barrel.
Get inside. I'll meet you in Manderly's office.
He does tend to whine at you if you kill too many people, although I don't think he's complaining about the...
What to do when we chase these sons of bitches into the
city. Okay, Kaplan.
Tell
hush,
you know.
Hush! Yes. I'll come back with once we've actually gone in here. UNATCO HQ!
Inside. I'll meet you in Manderly's office.
Which has...
Way to go, sir. I thought Gunther was a goner.
As I said, one of the best themes in terms of music in video gaming history.
Check in with Manderly on level 2.
Around the corner, a quick load, and into UNATCO. Ah. This is the ringtone on my phone. There's a reason for that. Let's listen to it.
Come on in. The retinal scanner can read blood vessel patterns right through your
skull. I'm just gonna shut up for the next minute and let you listen to this.
Remember that Mr. Manderly wants to see you. level 2. His secretary, Janice Reed, has your login and password.
Hell of a first day. We finally got to cap some rebels, eh, Denton?
You found your office. Did Janice give you your login? I guess not. Let's see. JCD, password, Bionic Man.
If I was you. JC. Mind if I call you JC? Glad to have you aboard. Just making the rounds.
You're just kidding around, right?
Okay, there you go. You've had enough of that and the nonsense. Emails, plenty of them. They have so many clues to the plot.
Before the briefing, you've got to go to level 3 for your equipment and a medical examination. See Jaime Reyes in the med center and Sam Carter in the armory.
Now, probably one of the most famous things about this, at least amongst those who've played the game quite some time, is if you go in the woman's toilets and they actually spot you in here.
How unprofessional.
Yes. Oh, how droll. Here, I'll throw this houseplant at you. Ah. How unprofessional is that?
Expecting a show.
Certainly hope not. JC Denton, the Class A pervert.
Don't think I won't report this.
I can't have you reporting this. That would be terrible. That would be awful. I'm not sure if I can actually completely stun her. Maybe I can. Right, first close the door so she can't get out. She's got a gun. That's a pepper spray. Okay. Go on, fall over. Fall over. Can I not actually kill her? I think she's gonna kill me with a pepper spray. Oh my god. Oh god.
This guy's just a rookie.
Yes, I'm so screwed. He has the assault rifle. Love it. Oh dear. Even though it's different death music depending on where you are. Love it.
How unprofessional.
Yeah, have this garbage can. Hi! You cannot escape! Is there anything else I can use? Be right back. No, sorry. I cannot allow it. Welcome to the jungle! We've got fun and games. You will never escape your water closet prison. Ah! Oh my god!
Expecting a show.
Get the hell away from me.
Well, that was a close one up there.
Yes, no kidding. She almost killed me. Right. Love this game. I've never seen anything do that. I've owned this game for 10 years and I've never seen that happen. Every time I play this game, I find something new. Even if it's just stupid, and it most frequently is. Ah, yes. Now, I do have some basic hacking ability, so might be worth checking that out. As I recall, I'm at NSF prisoners now.
Way to go, sir.
Thank you. Much appreciated. I'm glad to see somebody likes the way I'm acting.
Gunther should have followed orders.
Yes, he should. He is a German bastard. Right. Now, if I actually knew their passwords, and I'll be damned if I can remember them. Oh, God. No, I can't remember them. I'm trying to recall back in the depths of my mind. Can I remember the passwords for the stuff in here? Answer, no. Absolutely not. Quick information. A lot of different user accounts right here. Jay Bane will be joining us today. Yeah, don't want to stay out for too long because you will get electrocuted. Not a good idea. If you do get the passwords, however, then you'll be okay.
At ease, Agent Denton.
General Carter, I read about the Merced operation in school. This is a great honor.
I'm not a general. Just call me Carter.
I can't believe what the NSF did to your family.
Enough of that, soldier. Each have our troubles. I lost my children, but you've had to grow up without your parents, which requires more courage.
You can barely hear that. It's a good job I turned the subtitles on. I don't know. The volume levels in this game are often a little not so great.
Have your own op and time is short. How about I issue you a stealth pistol?
That sounds fine. Thank you, sir.
What else do you think you need?
Ammo, not so great. Smart lockpick's always good.
A smart lockpick is always handy.
That's right. Infiltrate and evade. Engage only on your own terms. Now move out. Manderley's waiting.
Hey, what about that guy out front selling munitions? Is that allowed?
Oh, Captain, right. We've got
someone at UNATCO's a thief.
Yes, sir. Damn good.
Indeed. There we go. Again, all of these tiny little pieces do actually end up in the story. In certain areas as you go through, you will eventually discover how they're all threaded together. This is why this is so well put together. You've got companies that hire Hollywood scriptwriters, and they think that this somehow makes a great game story, when in reality, what it requires is a dedicated developer that has ideas and is willing to thread them into the game world in such a way that you are they're not forced on you. You discover them at your own pace, or sometimes not at all. And that's great. This game does that. So Warren Spector, the guy who made this game, this is his finest work. He's sadly never beaten this. I would like to say that he has, but he hasn't.
You're red hot. Looks like you found me.
Yes, I did. He's all the way down there. He also has this, although I don't know what the key code is for this as of yet. Ah! There you go. That is Gunther Herman's password. We can log into his system if we so desire. I think we can do it from here, maybe. But it is a bit of a spelling test. There you go. So you can actually read all of this if you want. And Gunther Herman also is a terrible, terrible speller. There you go. Love it. Fantastic. Now, if I remember correctly as well, he's actually got a... There's a hidden... I don't know if you're able to access it now. I know for a fact he's got, like, a hidden thing somewhere. Can't remember where. There's a trap door in the floor somewhere. Is it around here? Maybe you can't get access to later.
Like leading a mouse to cheese.
This thing is starting to give me a headache.
Don't worry, we shut it down when you go off duty.
I guess I'll get used to it.
I'm Alex Jacobson, communications engineer.
I suppose you already know who I am.
Getting there. You're certainly quicker on the uptake than your brother Paul ever was.
Thanks.
Much appreciated. What else do we have information-wise?
Okay, JC? You're acting strange.
Totally cool, bro. Totally cool. That's what computers look like now.
I'll be watching your back.
I'm not sure how you're watching anything. All you've got are these, like, little green bars and a few tubes of water. It's impressive, nonetheless. Have this plant. It is a gift. No, seriously.
It'll be interesting to see how the transmission sounds in Manhattan.
Take the gift.
Okay, enough goofing around.
Oh, that kind of annoys me. I can't remember where his little secret compartment was. Oh, whatever. I know there's one in this room, so it might actually be in there. Okay. Medical lab. Get fixed up. Always a good idea. And we also have these two augmentations. Augmentations can be added to all of these different areas throughout the game as you find these little capsules. And they can also then be upgraded to four separate levels: microfiber muscle and combat strength. Combat strength is very nice if you want to use the baton an awful lot, because it will make it significantly better. Microfiber muscle will allow you to lift heavier objects, which also allows you to gain access to places you otherwise wouldn't be able to do. We're not really going to go too much further in this game. I'll say I'll finish the UNATCO area and then we'll cap it off, because it's been going on for a while anyway. So much lore. So look at it. There's so many of these things as well. There's like about 50 books in this game, and they're full of all manner of different pieces of information. Some of them contain news stories. Some of them contain excerpts from books. There is a series of books throughout it with a whole bunch of conspiracy theories and things in it. So cool. Down level 4. Well, the significance of this is not unveiled until much, much later. It's good. Trust me. And there's a sense of irony based on this little reflection right here. Possibly a sense of appropriateness, one way or the other. Can't get past that. The bypass strength is infinite. Not even throwing the American flag at it will make it move. Now, we need to go talk to Rames, and we also need to fix up that arm. It's a little bit screwed over. Find one of these bots, you can usually do it. They have a bit of a cooldown, but they're okay. There we go. Fixed up. Fantastic. They're fairly few and far between, as you might imagine. This corpse will contain a throwing knife. A single throwing knife. A pretty useless weapon, I might add. You got 4 rounds of them, and they do so little damage. They're just, and you get so few of them, they're barely worth it. But I believe you can usually recover them, so they're not the worst thing in the world.
Hey, JC.
You look like the real thing. They actually let you operate on people.
Just fixed Gunther's knee, in fact. A sticky actuator. So far, I feel more like a mechanic than a doctor.
I'm impressed.
They actually let you point a gun at people.
Well, yes.
I'll have to catch up later. I've got to leave for New York right away. Could you send Manderly whatever it is he wants?
No problem. Listen, JC, about your augmentations. You know they're preparing to roll out the technology worldwide, right?
As long as I don't turn green and grow a pair of antennas, as I understand it.
Yeah, well, the design's pretty modern.
Yes.
Right? Not yet. But remember,
I'll do that.
The canisters can.
It's about time, Liam.
Have you met your partner yet?
Skip. Yes, enough of that. Thank you very much. And also, we really need to get those settings right. Recording is a tricky business, folks.
I spill my drink.
Speech volume needs to be a little louder.
I spill my drink.
No. No more of that. Thank you very much. That's about it. I'm fairly sure there's a couple of other things lying around. You can actually break into some of the containers around the place if you desire. Although you have to do so little bit stealthily, because the guys around here don't like you doing that. They will actually shoot at you for it. It's not very nice. Oh, the stack's still there. Wonderful. Have this chair. It is a gift.
Hey, what the hell?
Right. Here we go.
Hello, Mr. Denton. I guess you're here to see Mr. Manderly. Welcome to UNATCO HQ. Our little family keeps getting bigger.
Is Mr. Manderly available?
Yes, go right in. By the way, your computer account is ready.
I already know. Thank you very much.
Alex already told me. Thanks.
It's wonderful that they actually acknowledge that as well. Great. Ooh, a key to the UNATCO closet. Handy. Which would be this, I believe. Always worth looking around before you waste things. Get yourself a free pepper cartridge and a caution wet floor sign. Here, I bring it to you as tribute.
You're going to make a mess.
No, I'm concerned about your safety, woman.
What's the idea, JC?
That's Mr. Manderley's information. J. Manderley? Janice with a winky smiley. You know they're doing it.
They're waiting for you, Agent. Go on in.
Thank you.
That will be JC's job.
What's that? Power station. The NSF have Ambrosia in a warehouse protected by cameras and booby traps. We want to power down the whole system.
We're taking one illicit generating plant, protected by weak groups of NSF. Knock out that plant, and Paul's team can walk right into the warehouse.
Just tell me where it is. The NSF are openly resisting our deployed forces, gradually falling back. You have to deal with them first.
And you be ready, Paul. When the power drops, go in and go in hard.
I'll use my discretion.
Go in like the U.S. Marshals. We lose the vaccine, I'm sending your butt to the mayor to explain why he and his three daughters won't get their pills this month.
Yes, sir. Let's not waste any time, JC. Get down to the dock. A boat is waiting to take you and your partner, Anna Navarre, to shore.
Yes, get moving. Here's your op bonus for the great job you did in the statue, plus 250 for rescuing Agent Herman. That's 1,250. We take care of our people around here.
Thank you, sir.
By the way, Denton, stay out of the ladies' restroom. That kind of activity embarrasses the agency more than it does you.
We'll meet up in the city.
Don't think I actually managed to do my whole pacifism thing. Fairly sure, because you usually get chewed out by them. I think maybe that explosion that I did before
and
that.
JC, try to follow orders this time. You'll come to admire your partner. She's one of our best. Leave from where you arrived, Denton. The boat dock. Move it. Move out, soldier.
No, I'm going to steal your candy bar and take a whiz.
Move out, soldier.
Denton, he won't talk to me. He doesn't like me anymore. I think he's pissed off that I knocked out the general at the end. Oh, God. Well, folks, that's pretty much about it. Although there is one last thing we do need to do.
Hell of a first day.
That's to go over and initiate the next level theme. Head on off on the boat.
Wish I was going with you.
If you were using a pirated version of this game, the boat would not be activatable and you'd never be able to get off the island. Don't steal games, kids. Not worth it.
Good luck out there. Man, two Dentons in the field. The NSF won't know what hit them.
Indeed. I would like to throw the stable lamp at you, but I'm not able to do so, so... Well, you may have this plant.
It's my first day, too. I'm pretty excited.
Yes, we have this ritual around here for first day. It's called Covered in Plants! Covered in plants!
You're just kidding around, right?
Somewhat. Only slightly. Only slightly.
Any more?
I think we'll have that scope.
I'll take
Thank you very much. There we go. And yes, I believe I can apply the scope, if I remember correctly, to that. There we go. Wonderful, wonderful zoom. Can't see anything. It's just the way that it goes. Okay. Time to get on a boat and get the hell out of here. There is... I don't know, there's just something magical about this game. I don't care about the terrible graphics, I don't care about the bad AI, I don't care about the limited sight range, I don't care about the bad voice acting, and the various other issues that this game has. This game is still just the best thing in the frickin' world. It, I think, was the one game... It actually was one of the first games I ever played when I had access to a PC, and I didn't really have access to a PC until I was about 16, and I was using a Risk OS Acorn Archimedes machine before that, so I had a very limited exposure to PC gaming. Very limited. We got like stuff that worked with ports and stuff that worked with the PC emulation card you could buy for that, which was kind of a neat piece of kit considering the time, but nonetheless, this was one of the first games I got when I got an actual PC, and it stays in my mind, it sticks in my mind from then as just being this huge horizon opening before me. And it just made me think, well, what a wonderful world gaming has now become. Look at all of these things that you can do within a game. Look at the freedom. Look at the choice. Look at the amount of thought that you can put into your actions in this particular title. And to me, it's just such a shame that only parts of that lesson were really learned. Deus Ex 2 was nowhere near as good. It was very restrictive. There were a whole bunch of problems with it. Some of the same basic ideas endured, but it just wasn't the game that we hoped it would be. Deus Ex 3 has had some very positive previews, and I do hope that it does live up to the legacy of its forefather, because as far as I'm concerned, Deus Ex is the finest game ever made, and perhaps may indeed be the finest game ever made of all time. We never know, especially if the world's going to end in 2012. We'll see. My name's been Totalbiscuit, and from the grey skies of Liberty Island, I bid you adieu.
Let's head out.